During IFA in Berlin earlier this year, Skagen introduced a new Faster 2 model, and I finally got my hands on this super interesting smartwatch that comes with Google's Wear OS. Hey, Martin here, and let's get started. The unboxing was pretty straightforward and easy. First of all, you've got some information on the box, and then of course you get the watch itself. Now there's also a magnetic charging cable, and there's some paperwork, and the presentation is really on spot. Now before I share all the good sides with you, there are a couple of downsides that you really need to know, because even though it is a really nice smartwatch, I think Skagen could improve with the next Falsten model even more and make it an even more interesting smartwatch than it already is. If you have a slightly thicker wrist than most men, then you might want to swap the wristband, as the standard one provided is relatively short. Now I'm always very active during the day, so I have my notifications running all day long. I have the heart rate sensor running 24 hours a day as well. And if you do some sort of an activity, the device will check automatically if you do, for example, walking or running. And I always have the automatic screen brightness turned on. Now the smartwatch will then easily survive you through the day. However, if you enable the always-on display, which is a nice feature of course, and GPS, you will make it through the day, but really barely. If it's like 8 o'clock in the evening, you most likely want to charge it, because then it's around 5 to 10% already, so the battery life is a bit on the short side. Now the Faster 2 is the very first smartwatch that I own that comes with Google's Wear OS, and right from the start, I have to say I'm kind of a really big fan of it. It works incredibly smooth, easy, and it is super responsive. However, just make sure that you update the watch and the app right away in order to receive all the functionalities and keep it smooth, as the chipset used in this watch over here is relatively outdated. Or let me say it like this, it is 2 years old. Regarding the watch itself and the good points, I'm super satisfied with the Skagen Faster 2, which is to be honest part of the Fossil group, and they have more well-known brands underneath their belt. Now, the watch itself feels solid and premium at the same time, but it would have been nice to have a slightly larger model available besides the 40mm case, because it might look a little bit girly on large wrists. The display has some really good contrast ratios, and the blacks are really deep blacks, making the relatively big bezel almost invisible. Now, the brightness of the screen is also more than good, as it is super easy to read the watch outside in bright daylight. Now I have the Mi Band 3 over here, and the score is really similar to the Skagen Faster 2 in terms of steps and the heart rate monitor. It's a nice indication that both measure it correctly. Because of Google's Wear OS, it is out of the box possible to reply to, for example, a WhatsApp message, which is really nice, but just keep in mind that it is a little bit difficult and tricky to type on this really small keyboard. I am, however, incredibly happy that they chose for Google's OS, because for the upcoming time you're guaranteed to receive updates, and the integration with Google Play, Google Fit, and the Google App Store is just perfect. Last but not least is the pricing for the Faster 2, which is $299 around Europe, and I think that is slightly on the high side. I think that a price between $200 and $250 is more justified, and it is a better price quality ratio. In the end, you always have to ask yourself whether or not you find the price quality ratio good, so whether or not you can afford it, or that you maybe prefer from another brand like Xiaomi, Huawei or Samsung. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comment section down below, what do you think of Google's Wear OS? What do you think of this Fossil brand, basically? What do you think of the Skagen brand? In the comment section down below. Or maybe you would like to see a full walkthrough of Google's Wear OS or something. So let me know in the comment section down below. Once again, thank you so much for watching. If you have some comments, questions or remarks, let me know in the comment section down below. And then I hope to see all of you in the next one.